What's cracking, my pan and zooming PD peeps? Thank you for watching this tutorial to learn how to make a pan and zoom effect for videos using the PowerDirector Mobile Video Editor app. A pan and zoom, or Ken Burns effect, creates movement in a still video or image, panning across the screen or zooming in and out, or both. It's a cool effect that has been used in videos for many years. Let's start a movement. I have a clip of a lady rocking out here in the timeline, playing on a guitar, doing a thizzang. Now, I want to go ahead and create a pan and zoom, but also add a little flair with a little effects. And I'll show you what I'm talking about. I want to move this playhead to a position where I want to end my first pan and zoom. And I'm going to tap on the clip, and I'm going to do split. And now I'm going to keep moving the playhead to different positions to create splits for when I do want to pan and zoom or when I don't want to pan and zoom. Now that I got all my splits created, I want to go ahead and create a pan and zoom on this first clip. So I'm going to tap on the first clip. And at the bottom of the screen where the effects are, I'm going to tap on pan and zoom. Now I'm going to tap on custom motion because I want to create my own specific pan and zoom. And for this one, I wanted to start full screen and zoom in. So I'm going to go to the end position and I'm going to pinch in and place this where I want it to be. Now I'm going to go ahead and tap on back. Then I'll tap on okay. Now the second clip, I wanted to just stay exactly how it was at its original position. But the third clip, I want to create another pan and zoom. So I'm going to tap on the third clip and I'm going to go down to the effects section and I'm going to tap on pan and zoom. And I'm going to go ahead and tap on custom motion. And this time I wanted to start zoomed in and end at the regular size. So for the start position, I'm going to pinch in and place this where I want it. And then I'm going to tap on back. And I'm going to go ahead and tap on OK. So now I got the pan and zoom effect on the first clip and the third clip. But I want to play some funky-fied transitions in between them to flare it up a bit. Because I got to make it flare up. You know how I do. So I'm going to tap on this first transition. I'm going to go to morphing. And I'm going to choose ripple morphing 1. Then I'm going to tap on the second transition. I'm also going to go to morphing. And here I'm going to do wave morphing 1. Then I'm going to go to the third transition. You guessed it, I'm going to morphing. And this time I'm going to go to ripple morphing 2. Now I'm going to go ahead and tap on back. I'm going to move my playhead to the beginning. Now we can play it back and see the results. Zoom, a zoom, zoom, and a boom, boom. You can also use the pan and zoom effect to create specific camera movements. If you want to learn how, be sure to check out this video. Don't forget to smash my logo to subscribe. Hit me up with your comments and drop me a like down below.